Hello everyone, welcome back to ChargerLAB. Several days ago, we released the teardown of Samsung 45W USB-C fast charging wall charger. You can click the right corner to see it. Today, we're gonna disassemble another Samsung 65W PD charger. But this product is not officially on sale right now, so the charger might be slightly different from the official version. And today's video is also limited to the analysis of the internal structure and components. Firstly, we can see the entire charger shell is pure white. The shell is made of frame retardant PC. Its surface is matted. The plug will be US standard and the single USB-C port is in the center. The front of the charger retains Samsung's tradition, a lightning logo and super fast charging are in the middle. The specifications of the charger are on the back. Model is EP-TA865. It supports wide voltage input of 100 to 240 volts, 50 or 60 Hz. Ready current is 1.7 amp. Output part will be 5 volts, 3 amp, 9 volts, 3 amp, 15 volts, 3 amp, 20 volts, 3.25 amp, and 3.3 to 21 volts, 3.25 amp. Made in Vietnam. As for the size, the length of the charger is about 50mm without pins, width is about 48mm, thickness is about 28mm. So power density is about 0.97 watts per cubic centimeter, which has also become the highest among Samsung's previous chargers. The weight is about 123.6 grams. Looks small, but you can obviously feel the weight in your hand. We can find the size of the entire charger is only half of the Apple 61W power adapter, and it's almost the same size as the Xiaomi 65W fast charger except for the fixed pins. Using ChargerLab Power Z KT002 to test the protocol, it supports Samsung 5V 2A DCP protocol and QC4, PD3, PPS, and other fast charging protocols. The tester also shows it has 4 fixed PDOs of 5V, 3A, 9V, 3A, 15V, 3A, 20V, 3.25 amp, and 3 sets of PPS PDOs of 3.3 to 11V, 5A, 3.3 to 16V, 4.3 amp, 3.3 to 21V, 3.25 amp. You can see the internal PCB module is covered with a large area of copper foil after opening the charger. The ChargerLab found this charger adopts switching power supply and protocol chip to control output. The front of the charger is some plug-in components, which are very compact. The back of the PCB will be SMD components. High voltage current comes in from the pins and go through the fuse and varistor firstly. Then the filtering and rectifier circuit here will use 3 high voltage electrolytic capacitors to filter the current. After stepping down through the transformer and rectifying and filtering again, it'll output under the control of the protocol chip eventually. The input side is a fuse of 2A. This green one is the varistor. It can short circuit the input and blow the fuse to protect the circuit when the input voltage is too high. After removing the filtering circuit of input side, you can see a rectifier bridge on the small PCB here, and there is a small inductor on it. Next, let's continue to remove 3 electrolytic capacitors for high voltage filtering. The first one is CapXon 400V 15 microfarad. The second one is CapXon 400V 22 microfarad. The third one is CapXon 180V 56 microfarad. Maybe you guys have noticed, the capacitor in here is different from the ordinary PD charger, which is smaller. As for why it can be like this, we will see it later. Continue to remove the transformer. There is a piece of plastic on the secondary side and the button of transformer, which used to support and insulate. The charger module is printed on the top. Thermal adhesive is filled between the transformer and the PCB. A little chip can be found in the middle. After cleaning the thermal adhesive, let's go ahead to see what's on the PCB. Here is a discharge chip for X capacitor from power integrations on the back. To avoid additional power consumption, it can discharge the X capacitor through the resistor after the AC is disconnected. This chip is highly reliable and easy to use. It can also improve the charger's energy efficiency. This one is MinE-CAP chip from power integrations. It is also the key to make the high voltage electrolytic capacitor smaller. It can automatically switch capacitors based on input voltage. For example, it'll use electrolytic capacitor of 180 volts 56 microfarad when the input is 110 volts. In this case, it can reduce the size. The front of the PCB is the master control chip of switching power supply, marked with SC1922C. This chip is customized by Samsung from Power Integrations. It integrates switching transistor, primary PWM controller, synchronous rectifier controller, etc. The synchronous rectifier MOSFET is next to the master control chip, which comes from Infineon. Another same MOSFET is on the back, and they are connected in parallel. Those two solid filter capacitors come from CapXon, used for synchronous rectification and output filtering. They were connected in parallel and the specification is 30V, 300μF. Here is the V-bus switching transistor and a protocol chip is on the back. This is a fast charging chip developed by Samsung, marked with M102X. The MM101 series is used in the Samsung 45W chargers we posted several days ago. This one should be the upgraded version. And there is also a VI capacitor between the primary and secondary circuit on the back, used for output anti-interference. The output adopts a customized USB-C port, which is covered with plastic and used for dust prevention. Well, that will be the teardown of latest Samsung 65W PD charger. Back in the September of last year, some media has revealed that Samsung is developing 65W PD fast charger. This one is very close to the final version. The charger uses power integration switching power supply chip and the latest MinE-CAP chip, which reduce the space occupation. The charger still supports PD3 PPS fast charging protocol, indicating that Samsung's next generation smartphone may support faster charging speed. Alright, that's all for today's video. You can click the corner to see the teardown of Samsung 45W USB-C fast charging wall charger, as well as other teardown videos you'd like. If you like this video, please drop a like and you can subscribe to our channel for more power-related content. See you next time!